discovery of the human leg. No further details about the discovery were made available. A second bomb threat in less than a week at a Milwaukee school. Milwaukee police tell the Journal Sentinel that a threat was made before the school day began at Milwaukee French Immersion School on Tuesday morning. Police searched the school but did not find anything, so the school day continued as normal. This comes after a bomb threat was made at the same school as well as Groppy High School and Highmount Community School on Friday. Police continue to seek an unknown suspect in both incidents. Also on Tuesday, a bomb threat at Brookfield Elementary was determined to be a swatting incident. Could an unprecedented decision in a Michigan court come to Wisconsin? Jennifer and James Crumley became the first parents sentenced for a conviction of involuntary manslaughter in a mass shooting on Tuesday. Criminal defense attorney Jonathan Lavoie tells WTMJ,
"Whether it comes to Wisconsin will really depend on the facts of the case. I think there has to be severe facts related to the parents' behavior, that the parents knew what was happening with the gun, that they provided the gun to the student, and that there were likely scenarios that could have prevented this."
The Wisconsin crime statute has party to crime liability, meaning those who aid or abet a crime can be held responsible. According to the latest government report, inflation isn't budging. Consumer prices were 3.5% higher in March than they were a year ago, inching upwards slightly and coming in slightly higher than expectations. ABC News reports shelter and gas are two areas that recorded higher prices, but prices for utilities and some grocery items decreased in March. Families are spending about $200 more a month than they were a year ago, and people are spending about $1,000 a month versus 3 years ago. Rent was one of the biggest reasons why prices were significantly higher or higher than expected in this latest government report. This has been your news update. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 101.7 The Truth.
Bringing you his authentic perspectives on important topics.
They live in suburbs together. They live in the city together. They hang out together, all in the same family. We're the only idiots that fight because we want our voice to only be on one side. Like, does that even make any sense? And when the side loses, you lose everything. They, on the other hand, have a voice no matter what, because somebody that looks like them is always in control.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point.
Well, it's just a skewed system.
Of course it is.
It's a lot of a judgment.
But answer my question, though. Should we let people go? Should we let people go? Like, let's just forget about bail altogether. And if your neighbor commits a homicide and kills people up. If you kill people and they next to you and you just let them come back and live right next to you, they can live upstairs from you. Let them come in your house.
Frank, candid and straight to the point. This is the best radio show in the state of Wisconsin. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth app.
Now, he's the mayor of the city of Milwaukee. He's a young man. Give him a chance. I only complain about things that I care about. What I want you to do is pretend like I'm in St. Louis. And all I'm asking the mayor and the Common Council president and the Common Council, show me.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Dr. Ken Harris.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. This is a cold jacket, isn't it? That's what's up. Yeah, I'm here with my Alpha Perion trying to represent. You know. All right, so let me finish doing this. I love doing everything live. So I need to click this, then I need to go over here. And then I need to scroll down, paste that there. Don't you love live radio? Enter. Setting up my StreamYard. Because I was too busy interviewing all over the place. Had an interview with WISN TV. And then I was on 620 talking about the whole issue with the body parts. And we'll have an update and talk about that a little later. But everything's so slow. You know, everything is slow. And so what I found out is if you go on Instagram, you have to unmute the Instagram Live. Otherwise, people can see you on Instagram, but they can't hear you. What? Yeah. Because somebody typed on there, hey, I can't hear you. Then I went, ah. I looked on and said, and the little icon was off. So I turned it on and I'm live on, yeah, X, YouTube, LinkedIn, Facebook, and Instagram. Okay. All right. That's what I get for doing 20 things at one time. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. So today we're going to be talking about one thing until you change the subject. But we're going to be talking about one thing, and that one thing is personal safety. And so we're going to go through some things people need to take time to do and think about and work their way through and really see what they can do in order to be safe. We may just have, and I don't know, and I'm not going to speculate. I've heard people talking about things like what this guy from the South Side was arrested and stuff he had and didn't have and all this. And I'm like, you know what? Be quiet. Let the Sheriff's Department, who's leading the investigation, and the Milwaukee Police Department and the FBI and everybody do their job. All right? Be quiet. Stop making assumptions. Stop taking this family through grief where they may or may not be and all that. Let's let the DNA come back. Let's let all those things occur so that we can understand, we as in Truth Nation can understand and get a clear understanding of what exactly is going on with this case. And that's it. There are chain of evidence issues as it relates to making sure it's done right. They're taking care of it. They're getting DNA checked. And the detectives from the Sheriff's Department, the detectives from Milwaukee, probably state CIB, any neighboring jurisdictions, the Stack Center, all these places, Milwaukee police detective, everybody's working, FBI. Everybody's going to be working and taking their time and moving slow. We know the family may be in agony if it ends up being their missing loved one. There may be multiple missing loved ones. The DNA may find one person or may find three or four or ten. We don't know. And until we do, stop speculating about what you don't know. Stay off of social media. You know what you can do? You can stay right here. And we'll talk about what it takes in order to be safe. Your personal safety. What are some of the things you need to look out for? Now, this is educational. This is by no means training. It's by no means, you know, the end of the, you know, line. This is the word. This is it. This is it. Nope. This is just not even suggestions. It's just educational information that you can choose to use, not use, support, not support, say it's right, say it's wrong. It's up to you. But in the end, something has to be done so that people in Milwaukee are safe. Now, let me get this out of the way. And let me take this jacket off because I'm smoking hot. Oh, wait, look at what's under it. The truth. That's right. I got Truth, Concordia, and Alpha Phi Alpha. So I'm just loving it. But what it comes down to is this. We're going to have to look at if this white guy did it, if this white guy from Southside, everybody all of a sudden now is thinking he's strange, but y'all didn't say nothing before when you thought he was strange. But now he's strange. Okay. So now that we have this issue, if a white person did it and then dumped the bodies and dumped the body parts on the north side with a leg on the south side, is that indicative of some Jesse Anderson-esque actions, you know, where he stole the ball cap from the black kid in an effort to get his, bought it from him in an effort to get his DNA that he could put at the scene and then say that it was some black guy that killed his wife and he got caught because the guy turned him in? And I happen to know the person. But think about that. Now we have body parts dumped 3 different areas in Milwaukee County, north side of the city, and then one in southern Milwaukee County near Cudahy, in Cudahy in Wanamount Park. So instead of trying to ask questions as to why, let's get a handle on what. What do we have today? What exactly is going on? We talked about it yesterday with Julia Fellow from 620 WTMJ Breaking News Center. We've talked about it all day today, but what we have to do is be respectful to the family in the event it is a missing person from Milwaukee. And so the question then remains, how long? You have to get probable cause set. In 48 hours, you got 72 hours total because you can get a 3-day extension. And that's it. You got 5 days. They're waiting for the DNA to come back. They put a rush on it. And it'll be back Wednesday or Thursday. And then they'll have answers. And so then the question is, what if it's not? What if it ends up being 3 different people? What if it ends up being not, like, there's so many different scenarios that we need to stop. We're talking about the guy and whether or not he had digging in his yard and this and that, and it doesn't matter. Let law enforcement professionals do their job and create something that's meaningful in relation to evidence. Well, not create, but track. I don't want them creating evidence, but tracking so that they can make sure every I is dotted, every T is crossed, and there's a chain of evidence for the DNA, for the physical evidence, everything, that the reports are in order. And it will be. And it will be. Like, this is literally what they do. And so this is one of those times where we want the police to actually do their job. Yes, people complain about the police all the time, and they moan, and, oh, my God, I can't believe it. The police didn't do their job for the 1 or 2 out of the hundreds that do it right every day. In this instance, for the sake of the family, for the sake of the actor, right? What if he's wrong? What if, right? What if? Let's not go there. What if it's him? What if it's not? Did he do this? Is it that? Is it this person? Is it that person? You have no information. You have no evidence. And just because things were found in one place and they might have been brought from another, we don't know. And so the sooner we're patient, allow the family to settle in so that they can understand what's going on and assist if necessary, we'll find out something in due time. But when we come back, I want to talk about personal safety. I want to talk about some of the things we need to start doing in Milwaukee that we may not have been doing in Milwaukee to make sure we're safe. Our families are safe. We spend an inordinate amount of time making sure children are safe, but we don't make sure our young men and our young women are safe. So when we come back, I'll be talking about it from both sides, the law enforcement side, the community side, and the victim side. I'll have Tory Lowe return, and we'll chop it up about what people are saying and ways they can actually mess up the case. So even to the point where when they try to find a jury, you've put so many ideas out there that you, that it takes you too long to actually find 12 jurors and an alternate who aren't biased enough against somebody so they can get a fair trial. And so the victims can be fairly heard so that if the person is guilty, they find them guilty. But when you taint everything with innuendo and hearsay, it'll just take that much longer. And what it really comes down to every day, 24 hours a day, no matter what, it comes down to personal safety.
And that is Dr. Ken's Truth on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Milwaukee, we are in the heart of the basketball season, and we have all the local hoops news you need to hear. Get your weekly smile on with our Nothing But The Truth basketball report, brought to you by Bubon Orthodontics. On Nothing But The Truth, we'll keep you in the loop on all the local Milwaukee hoops news, from high school all the way to the pros. So don't miss your shot to join in on the hoops talk by tuning into The Truth Basketball Report on Nothing But The Truth, right here on the new award-winning 101.7 The Truth, brought to you by Bubon Orthodontics, the official smile of the Milwaukee Bucks.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella Windows. The luxurious look, sleek design, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home the extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. At Pella, we see windows differently. We have the highest rated energy efficient products and a complete range of durable, functional, and high quality products that bring out the best of your home. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. That's right, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit amfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Come in with straight truth.
And the truth was, after November 3rd, after the election, poof, it was over. It was a political idea. I don't have to wait till it's said and done to realize we got played. I said it back then, and I stood 10 toes on it. I said, this ain't no black movement. This something else. Just because it say Black Lives Matter, I started looking at the movement and what was going on, and I said, this is a political agenda.
Catch the Tory Lowe Show every weekday from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. Hey, you tired of training your boss? I guess I should ask Jason that. A degree from Concordia University can help you get the promotion you've actually earned. I mean, that's what I did. That's how I got promoted to sergeant and lieutenant. Got a second bachelor's degree, master's degree. Concordia University, Wisconsin offers flexible online career-focused programs for experienced adults like us. So whether you're looking to grow your current role, enter a new role, just pick up some extra information about something that you like to do and that it's a hobby, whatever it is, Concordia can help you learn from experts and grow your professional network. For more information, check out CUW.edu. That's CUW.edu, my alma mater. For more information, 833-212-1017 is the number. In the studio with me is T-Lo. What's going on?
Hey, how are you doing, Dr. Ken?
I'm good. This, I hope it's not a serial killer. I hope. But we've had so many. You know, I mentioned it maybe 6 months ago. I mentioned it again a couple weeks ago. You know, we had a lot of missing people in Milwaukee.
Right.
I mean, it just seemed more than normal.
Well, you know, I'll say this. You know, we worry when our loved ones don't respond in their usual patterns. And then when we go to check and they're not where they're supposed to be. And then that's when you go into the missing mode where I guess some people will go file a report. But really, I say that the person is missing when they're not functioning in their normal behavior, you know, at work.
Right.
Calling, you know, if they're a caretaker.
I talk to them every day, right. And I didn't talk to them.
So to me, that's when I try to, if I can get it that early, I like getting it that early. But sometimes they go and file the missing report.
Right.
And I think it takes 24 hours unless it's a
critical. That's what the law says, right? Unless it's a critical missing.
It's a critical missing. So, like I said, due to the fact that I'm an advocate and a mother can call me and say, hey, Tory, my daughter didn't show up for school or something unusual happened, I can get on it that early, you know, because I don't have to go by those rules. But the thing is, it's just a horrible situation to believe that their loved one may be in a situation.
And nobody's doing anything.
And nobody knows what's going on, right? Yeah.
So we know the guy's name. We know that he's a person of interest.
Mm-hmm.
They have probable cause for the arrest, and now they're waiting, and they had it extended for the 3 days, the 72 hours. You have 48 hours to show you had probable cause for the arrest, and then you got to wait another. And then another 24 hours to charge this person, right? But they extended it 72 hours.
If I
have my memory right as a lieutenant, to actually gather extra information.
Right. And the thing is, that's what's needed because they have evidence. They just got to, you know, make sure that it all correlates to what they're trying to charge them with. And I think that right now.
No.
Well,
they just have evidence.
Well, what I'm saying is they're trying to put it all together to see what's going on.
Right. Right. And so some people will take the first part of what you said and go, oh, it's evidence against him. No, we don't have evidence against him.
Well, the thing is,
we have evidence and we want to make sure that it does or doesn't match the person.
Well, to prove what you're saying, I've had people on the hook that I thought was on the hook.
And they're not.
And they let them out.
Right.
Okay,
right.
So I've seen it happen like that.
Oh, yeah.
But I think that many times we just want to see something happen.
Right.
And when I say these situations can get spooky, it's because now your
You're not the first person to use that word.
Now your mind is starting to run wild.
Right.
And because you don't see your loved one, because they're not present, and then you see a car that's been, you know, tampered with, then you see clothing laying around, things in parks, and all of a sudden it just becomes this huger fright that your loved one
may be
unalived at that point.
And we don't know if somebody, other than the person that's in custody, took advantage of it and threw the clothes there.
Right.
We don't know if it's the person's remains or not. Like, all that has to take, it has to evolve. And really what we need is for people to be patient.
Well, with this much evidence gathered, I think that it's secure enough to say that let the system do its job.
Say that again.
Well, you know, with all that they've collected.
Right.
Now we just got to let the system do their job.
Yeah. And if it's connected, it's connected. If it's not, it's not. You can't make it what it's not. any more so than you don't want it to be connected to him and it ends up being connected.
And that's what you had to explain as a, when you was working as a police officer. I'm sure that you had to get in a lot of these conversations. Right. But, you know, but me as an advocate, my job is to just be whatever the family needs me to be at that time. Like, and if they need to go on, like I call it wild goose chasing.
Yeah, but like, now like, you're trampling over evidence.
What I'm saying is sometimes somebody like they'll get on social media and be like, oh, we saw on the bus stop. Or she was just at this place over here. So you can't tell the family, oh, this was what happened.
Because it's public. Because, you know, they can go where they want to go.
So I figure it only takes 20 minutes to go over there and check, you know.
Right.
So many times I don't say anything. I just go with them to make sure that everything is done decently in order instead of them having them just going all over the place, just running around and just releasing energy, angry energy out into the community. So it's just best sometimes to just to be an advocate and making sure that things are, you know, looked at or perceived well when it comes to your loved one being missing.
But people have to also remember that there's an investigation going on. And what you don't want to do is go in and trample over evidence that they then can't use.
Well, the thing is, you know, sometimes when I'm dealing with situations, they don't have this much evidence with the stuff that's going on with the parks and this much police involved.
Right.
So most of the time is we're trying to bring awareness that this person is actually missing.
Missing.
And
like
actually
they need like
help.
Initially missing and we need to report them.
We need some activity going on, right?
Like we just need a one time acknowledge that she's gone. He's gone.
But this situation they have
the
manpower involved. And like I said, now you sit tight because they do have things that they can put together and let's see what happens.
Right. So we'll see. We shall see. And I know you'll keep your eye on it the whole time. And
of course.
We'll follow along and make sure that people are informed of the correct information that has been vetted versus social media.
But you see the headlines.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the headlines, body parts all over Milwaukee County. Like, you see that the news ain't helping it out. They sensationalizing the whole thing. So, like I said, it's going to cause people to, you know, you read headlines like that, and you're like, what's really going on? Is it multiple bodies? Is it one? Right. What's really going on here?
And so we will find out. We'll find out sooner than later. We'll find out whether or not this matches a missing or if it's unknown.
Mm.
And we'll go from there.
Well, you know, every now and then Milwaukee get a character that pop up.
Well.
And, you know.
Are you trying to say we're overdue?
No, I'm just saying it happens, you know, when we see these different characters pop up. And we just say, how did this person slip through the cracks? How did this happen?
Right. Very true. But you, I don't know if you can say slip through the cracks because I think previously this person only had like a either disorderly conduct or a, you know, a battery charge with the sheriff's office back in like 2019 or something.
Right.
So I don't know if you can connect dots when there's no dot to connect.
Right. Well, what I'll say is that, you know, when a loved one, you know, this is why I say it's always good to be in a business sometimes when you have, especially girls, you know, I got daughters. And when they off with the phones, I make sure, hey, who are you talking to? Who is that? You know, trying to make sure I'm nosy enough to make sure that I can respond quick enough and just in case something takes place.
Yep, absolutely. Thank you, sir. I appreciate you.
Hey, I appreciate you for having me, Doc.
Yeah, we'll be. Guaranteed you'll get at least 5 hours a day of what's going on and updates. And
well, hopefully tomorrow we'll have more.
Yeah, the DNA will be back tomorrow or Friday, and we will know definitively whether or not he's a suspect.
Right.
Yeah. All right. Thank you much.
All right. Thanks for having me, Dr. King.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I am your host, Dr. King Harris. Traffic, sports, and weather up next.
More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. This is your Versity Blood Center of Wisconsin Community Impact Moment on 1017 The Truth.
What was the life change? You know, we all know it happened and we know things happen and you have bad kidneys, but what was the life change afterwards?
A couple things. Before they even allow you to get on the list, they make you go through a battery of tests. And, you know, a lot of people don't qualify because they're overweight or they have high blood pressure or high cholesterol. Or, so all those things are requirements before you can even get approved to be on the list. So I had...
You got to be approved to be on the list?
Absolutely.
Wow.
It's interesting. There's a professional athlete or former professional athlete I know right now that has kidney disease and he's on dialysis and he wants to get on the list and he's not accepting all the things you have to do, you know, to get on the list. But yeah, so for me, I spent 30 years in the automobile industry. You know, that's 12, 14 hour days, eating whatever somebody brings you to eat, whatever you run out and grab, McDonald's, whatever. It was never salads and, you know.
Yeah, but that was a choice, right?
It was a choice. Yeah. But I had to change all of that to even qualify to be on the list. I had to get down to the weight I had to be at. I had to get my phosphorus under control, my potassium under control.
Wait a minute, even though somebody said they would give you a kidney,
absolutely,
you had to still make yourself eligible?
Absolutely.
Nah, that's okay.
When I mentioned the athlete, his relative actually died, and they wanted to take his organs, and they couldn't because he wasn't qualified. He wasn't on the list.
Wow.
Yeah, you have to be.
So there are over 100,000 people on that waiting list, so they are very serious.
And how many donors do we have?
And that's the problem. We don't have nearly enough donors.
Wow. Okay.
And that's why it's such a critical need. But they are serious about who they're giving that gift of life to because there are so many people who are literally dying waiting for it.
To make an impact by donating blood in your community, visit Versity.org today.
When you're high, you feel different. Pretty obvious, right? You think different, talk different, but if you feel different, you drive different. So if you're high, just don't drive. Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Are you or anyone you know looking for a job? Direct Connect MKE is a social media style platform that empowers you to grow your social network, find career opportunities, and connect with career specialists for success. Visit joindcmke.com today to learn how you can create a profile, upload your resume, and find access to information about jobs, job training, hiring events, and more. DCMKE is locally focused and equips you to grow your social capital and find opportunities that match your career interests. Visit joindcmke.com today and connect your dream to reality.
The traffic and weather update on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by the City of Milwaukee's Direct Connect MKE. Make connections and explore career opportunities by visiting directconnectmke.com. Delays continue on southbound 41, basically from just south of Appleton Avenue all the way down past Capitol Drive. Northbound's a bit heavy, heading around the North Avenue curve up towards Burleigh. We've got southbound 894 backing up from Greenfield Avenue down and around the hail interchange, with the westbound side out of the Mitchell heavy out to 68th Street. By the way, 894 eastbound, there is an accident off on the right shoulder at the from the ramps from 76th Street, so something to keep in mind if you're heading through that area. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight, increasing clouds, a low of 46. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy, scattered showers and thunderstorms with a high of 56. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 101.7 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Julian Johnson. The Milwaukee Bucks get back in the win column after defeating the Boston Celtics 104-91 Tuesday. The Bucks hit the hardwood again versus the Orlando Magic tonight at Fiserv Forum. Coverage begins at 6:30 on 94.5 ESPN. The Milwaukee Brewers are now 7-3 to start the season. They defeated the Cincinnati Reds Tuesday 9-5. They face the Reds again tonight. Coverage begins at 5:05 on our sister station, 620 WTMJ. The Green Bay Packers are heading to Brazil for week one of their 2024 season. They'll play the Philadelphia Eagles in Sao Paulo on September 6th. This is the NFL's first ever game in South America. This sports update is presented by Associated Bank, proudly supporting our hometown teams, member FDIC.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. So, Truth Nation, join Truth Team on Saturday, April 13th at our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. He was just here, wasn't he? We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com. That's truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up to be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. I won't be there. I'll be at the Alpha Convention. Anyway, everyone who joins gets a free lunch provided by Cousin Sub. That's what I'm actually mad about. I can't be there, and y'all going to get some lunch, and I'm going to be stuck working. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com. Clean, beautify our city right here together. Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored gladly by Cousin Sub Waste Management and Safe and Sound. 833-212-1017 is the number. So, I want to talk about personal safety, but first I want to kind of tell you that this is more so educational than anything, right? It's not meant to convince you to do something that you don't want to do, convince you to go somewhere you don't want to go, convince you anything, just information, education. That's it. That's it. So personal protection is something that is important to everybody. Doesn't matter who you are. Doesn't matter what you do. And after this, I'll get to the talk and text line. Whether you work in social service, whether you're just a business person, whether you're a student, if you're going to school or going to work or retired, it really doesn't matter. To be safe and secure in your person, places, and effects is your constitutional right. And when that doesn't happen, even if it happens to somebody else, you can feel unsafe even though you haven't been a victim. And so it's important to remember that. Observation is important in terms of what you're doing each and every day. Everybody in your family should be looking out for safety and security. If you have any questions or comments, 833-212-1017 is the number. I want to know, what is your objective to being safe? Like, what do you do to keep yourself safe in the city of Milwaukee? You know, because sometimes we just go through stuff and just do stuff and don't really think about it. Do you check the area? Do you look left, look right? You ready? Do you look behind you? Do you look up? All those things. Talk about being alone. How are you safe in your car if you get into an accident? What do you do? If you're female or male, or it doesn't matter nowadays, when you're in a car and you get in an accident, well, how did the accident happen? How do you do all that? Or are there some universal things you can do that simply start with calling 911? Carjacking, coded language, when someone's talking to you and you get a feeling that they're going to harm you based on their tone, the words they're using, that kind of stuff. You know, lighting, go outside and it's dark, or go outside too early. Recognizing that, you know, your police response time, like, may not be on your side. Like, they might be busy, and you call 911, and they say, we'll send a squad. And squad's coming from, like, District 4, and you live in on the northwest side, and you live in District 6 on the southeast side, close to the lake. Good luck with that. But those are the things you have to think about. How to assess risk, robbery, suspicious people. What makes a person suspicious? And if you're black, are you scared of black men, groups of black boys walking down the street? And is that a form of racism? Okay, I digress. Theft, unsafe neighborhood. What makes a neighborhood unsafe? So for all intent and purpose, I don't know if you can look at a neighborhood and say that neighborhood's unsafe, but I know there's certain elements that are the same in every neighborhood when they're unsafe. And then we'll talk about, just if you're working somewhere and somebody walks in on you, What do you do? What should you do? What can you do? All those things. And so these are some of the things I want to explore this evening. And if you have any questions, 833-212-1017. We're going to be talking about being outdoors, being in a car, being at work, visiting somebody, going to see your sister, your brother, your cousin, your parents. What happens, right? Interesting. Let me go back to the talking text line. That's a lot. This guy has blood all over his house. He obviously did it. Why are you trying to stick up for him? Well, that's dumb, Nick. Come on now, Nick. That's dumb of you to say I'm trying to take up for him. What I'm doing is making sure, like every other person in America wants, you want there to be an investigation and they find information and find you guilty. What we don't want to do is jump to conclusions when we don't have information. Dude, I'm sure if you walk through my house right now, you could find some blood. Does that mean I killed somebody? I'm sure. You know why? Look at this. See this? Yeah. That's called a bandage. I took one off and I cleaned it and I put a new one on. Not the bandage, but my arm. What does that mean? That means what? There's blood on it. Hey, we went in this house and we found a bloody bandage. Oh, there's blood in this house. I'm saying everybody gets the same investigation. Everybody gets the same benefit of the doubt until there's evidence of the contrary. I'm not taking up for him. If he did it, he should go to jail. Should go to prison. Anyway, somebody did it, and it wasn't Junebug from around the way. That's true. Brian said, here's a tip for black females in Milwaukee. Stop. Okay, I don't know what that means. Nick said, you're acting like this is some regular murder. There are body parts all over Milwaukee, and this guy has blood all over his house. He obviously did it. No, he didn't. Until you prove that the blood is the blood that came from the bodies, the body parts. Number two, it's in three places. And then there's one down in Cudahy. So why don't you just be vigilant and be careful? Why can't you do that? Ray said the problem is that we have today is these types of cases is that we have people on social media saying all sorts of things. When we had Jeffrey Dahmer, Facebook was just barely getting off the ground. There were no people all over social media. That's true. That is true. And now you got people that are all over the place doing all kinds of things. I went and got my it's not a CCW, it's a CCL. It's a concealed carry license. So if you're gonna trash me, make sure you get it right. He said he bought some Kevlar. You're going to sew it into his jacket. You know that's pretty darn heavy. You know that, right? You know that's pretty heavy. And then Nick said, there were 5 murders on my block alone last summer. I would consider that unsafe. Yes, I would definitely consider it unsafe. Daisy, you're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Well, I'm Latina. My kids are half black, half Hispanic. Mm-hmm. I live on the north side of Wisconsin. I'm a third-time felon. I can't carry no guns. So what I tell my children is I teach them basic safety skills. Like you said, look left, look right. And I carry a big old stick with me everywhere I go.
Don't you carry that? Hang on. Don't you carry that stick so that you can walk better, right?
I could.
No,
yes,
no.
Exactly
you didn't answer my question. You carry that stick so you can walk better, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I do.
Okay.
But you always have to be paying attention because with kids, they be running around. I've seen kids get snatched up. I live in Texas before. I always tell my kids, if you are an arm's length away from me, that is too far.
I should not
reach you. They'll come and snatch you up within an instant. So I have a rule. My kids, my belt hoops. I attach them to me literally with Velcro. They hold them on the wrist and they walk with me because I just don't know. Nowadays, you just don't know. we got family members breaking into homes, you know, so everybody, nobody's safe in Milwaukee.
I wouldn't go that far. I don't know if I would go that nobody's safe in Milwaukee.
It depends where you are in the city. My mom, she is 75 years old, and she got robbed in Third Ward, one of the nicest little areas over here on the southeast west of Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she couldn't do nothing about it, but like you said, call 911.
Yep, very true. But here's why I say what I say before we go to break. You ready?
Yep.
A dangerous weapon is any firearm, whether loaded or unloaded, any device designed as a weapon and capable of producing death or great bodily harm, any ligature, that's rope, or any other instrumentality used on the throat, neck, nose, or mouth of another person to impede partially or completely breathing or circulation of blood, any electric weapon, or, and here's the part, any other device or instrumentality which, in the manner it is used or intended to be used, is calculated to or likely to produce death or great bodily harm. So if I have a stick and I'm walking down, and this is my don't take this as legal advice. If I have a stick and I'm walking down the street, my interpretation is that's either a weapon. If you say, yes, I have this stick because I'm using it to defend myself because I'm scared, it instantly becomes a weapon. Because it's an instrumentality that when used in a certain manner or intended to be used, is calculated or likely to produce death or great bodily harm if you beat somebody with it. But if it's your cane and you're walking down the street and use it as a cane so you can walk, that's different. I'm just saying.
Right. Yep. You're absolutely right.
I'm just saying. But that's my
thanks.
That is not an interpretation. You should call the district attorney's office in your particular county ask them what it is. All right. Well, you take
care
of the kids, girl.
I enjoy your show every day, all day. I will.
All right. I appreciate you, Daisy. Take care.
Yeah.
But that's one of those things, you know, like if some people think, you know, we have this thing in our brain. Oh, I know the law. You can't do that because their friend told them. Only to find out later. They're joining their friend. You know what I'm saying? Hey, garage doors giving you headaches, snow, rain, shine like it is now. I'm here to tell you it's irritating to have to deal with a malfunctioning garage door, and the best way I know how to deal with it is to call my friends at Geis, and they'll get you right. Geis is family-owned and operated since 1955 and are trusted authority on garage doors and openers in southeastern Wisconsin. Trust me, I use them too. Geis has garage doors, openers for every budget, and can even build custom designs to meet your exact preferences. So if you have a conventional garage door, if you have a historic home, or if you're building brand spanking new, for fast, reliable garage repair solutions, go to geisdoors.com. That's G-E-I-S doors, all one word, .com. Or call 262-784-4250. That's 262-784-4250. Don't think twice. Call Geis.
Don't touch that dial. More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, tune in Wednesday night at 6 p.m. for the Thanalysis podcast and the award-winning 1017 The Truth. Thanalysis will be joined by Duke basketball legend Jay Williams and Bucks guard Malik Beasley. They will have a real conversation about life as well as deep dives of the NBA world. Do not miss the Thanalysis podcast on The Truth Wednesday night at 6 p.m. on 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. And so We went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We have already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
Your drink, sir?
This virtual vacation is brought to you by Milwaukee Mitchell International Airport. For the full experience, visit flymke.com to explore our many nonstop destinations. With super convenient parking and low fares, flying from Milwaukee makes traveling so easy, it's like starting your vacation early. Fly easy, fly MKE.
Wisconsin is as hardworking of a place as you'll ever find. There's a sense of pride, community, and work ethic that's second to none. People here are tough, but even the toughest among us need help after a serious accident. At Gruber Law Offices, we won't stop fighting for you and your family. We've been here and will continue to be here for as long as you need us. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Coming with straight truth.
And the truth was, after November 3rd, after the election, poof, it was over. It was a political idea. I don't have to wait till it's said and done to realize we got played. I said it back then, and I stood 10 toes on it. I said, this ain't no black movement. This something else. Just because it say Black Lives Matter, I started looking at the movement and what was going on, and I said, this is a political agenda.
Catch the Tory Lowe Show every weekday from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. Hey, I want to tell you, Truth Nation, we're excited for all the official launches and all this stuff that's going on this week. We got something great for you. Jamming with Juice this Thursday at 6 o'clock. Jamming with Juice is a Truth exclusive YouTube series hosted by our very own Carrie Noni and Ben Jamming. So make sure you're tapped in by subscribing to 1017 The Truth on YouTube so you don't miss the debut of Jamming with Juice this Thursday at 6 o'clock. I'm going to critique them. Every single, every word, everything they say, because you know it's going to be great, so I can just say that now. I don't have to critique them later. It's going to be great. Milwaukee Black Talk just keeps getting better. Jamming with Juice, Carrie Noni, Ben Jamming, hanging out live on YouTube. Check it out. 833-212-1017 is the number. I got my top five at five coming up. There's just so much that's going on. And I want to touch right quick because I have a few minutes. How do you process threats? Like, what's threatening to one person may not be threatening to another. When the police shoot somebody, it has to be the actions of what a reasonable police officer would do. So how do you process things that are nonverbal? Well, here's some of the things that I think we look at and we do when there's something that we're doing or there's something that we think is a threat, or we don't think it's a threat and it actually is. nonverbal cues, verbal cues, somebody telling us, hey, man, I'm a whoop yo so-and-so, right? That's a threat. But if I just look at you and stare at you and look at you and go, mm-hmm. Yeah. Or is it? Somebody might take that as a threat. What about the training you've received? I have a fairly high threat level, right? So I don't like freak out when stuff happens because of training. What about experience, upbringing? What about race and ethnicity? Because, you know, nothing good happens south of Highway 60 because, you know, them people that I mean. Nothing happen south of, you know, the Ozaukee County line because, you know, them people live down there. Which is why I don't go up north. You know why? Because them people live up there. No, I'm just kidding. So you have gender. Sometimes you feel more vulnerable if you're a woman or a man or of smaller stature, regardless of race. All those things are taken into account as it relates to how you process, how you do those types of things. And so you have to remember safety, the habits you have, trusting your instincts. We'll talk about all that in the 5 o'clock hour. We got top five at five coming up. And we're going to jump on this story. Any updates we have on the body parts that were found and the person of interest that's in custody. And we'll jump back in some personal safety tips and discussion so that we can do that. We'll even hit the talking text line because they talking crazy now. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. Top five up next.
Don't touch that dial. More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, Gruber Law Offices, and The Truth have raised the stakes for this year. The One Call, That's All Gruber Cash giveaway is now a 5K giveaway. Yes, you heard it right. $5,000 giveaway. Every weekday on 1017 The Truth, you will have the chance to be entered to win the 5K giveaway. Listen to The Truth for the One Call, That's All cue to call for your chance to win $5,000. Gruber Law Offices, One Call, That's All. Visit 1017thetruth.com for official contest rules.
1017 The Truth and Associated Bank have teamed up for our Black-owned business give back. Each quarter, we'll be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to five Black businesses. To sign up for your business's chance to win $6,000 of commercial campaign marketing on the award-winning 1017 The Truth, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure on The Truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, member FDIC.
One smile is great, but one smile in a community of smiles is so much better. A smile has a secret power that most people don't know about. A smile multiplies. It spreads from one person to the next, stretching across entire groups of people. Smile Train knows this and is proud to be creating a wave of smiles across the cleft lip and palate community. In over 70 countries. Patients, doctors, advocates, fundraisers. Collectively, our smiles are a celebration of the transformed lives of over 1.5 million children. Learn how Smile Train is helping the cleft lip and palate community at smiletrain.org/learn. Smile Train, changing the world one smile at a time.
I'm Shanola Hampton. Every day, millions of people face hunger. Today, I will share with you some of their experiences. I'm stuck between paying for medications or paying for food. John from Maine. After paying my bills, I can buy groceries. It's sad to say, food comes last. Alice from Oregon. I thought pantries were for less fortunate people. But anybody could be less fortunate in a day or even a second. Claire from Virginia. The Feeding America Network of Food Banks helps provide over 6 billion meals to people in need each year. No one should have to worry where their next meal will come from. Together, we can end hunger. Learn more at feedingamerica.org.
Breaking news, weather, entertainment, and sports. We have it all here. This is 101.7 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station. This is your 101.7 The Truth news update.
I'm Julian Johnson. An update on the human remains story. Two items were discovered at Warnemont Park in Cudahy that could be linked to the severed leg found at the lakefront last week. Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office says an individual at the park came across the items Tuesday afternoon. The Sheriff's Office believes the items may be related to its ongoing investigation into the discovery of the human leg. No further details about the discovery were made available. A second bomb threat in less than a week at a Milwaukee school. Milwaukee police tell the Journal Sentinel that a threat was made before the school day began at Milwaukee French Immersion School on Tuesday morning. Police searched the school but did not find anything, so the school day continued as normal. This comes after a bomb threat was made at the same school as well as Groppy High School and Highmount Community School on Friday. Police continue to seek an unknown suspect in both incidents. Also on Tuesday, a bomb threat at Brookfield Elementary was determined to be a swatting incident. Could an unprecedented decision in a Michigan court come to Wisconsin? Jennifer and James Crumley became the first parents sentenced for a conviction of involuntary manslaughter in a mass shooting on Tuesday. Criminal defense attorney Jonathan Lavoie tells WTMJ,
"Whether it comes to Wisconsin will really depend on the facts of the case. I think there has to be severe facts related to the parents' behavior, that the parents knew what was happening with the gun, that they provided the gun to the student, and that there were likely scenarios that could have prevented this."
The Wisconsin crime statute has party to crime liability, meaning those who aid or abet a crime can be held responsible. According to the latest government report, inflation isn't budging. Consumer prices were 3.5% higher in March than they were a year ago, inching upwards slightly and coming in slightly higher than expectations. ABC News reports shelter and gas are two areas that recorded higher prices, but prices for utilities and some grocery items decreased in March. Families are spending about $200 more a month than they were a year ago, and people are spending about $1,000 a month versus 3 years ago. Rent was one of the biggest reasons why prices were significantly higher or higher than expected in this latest government report. This has been your news update. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris continues on 101.7 The Truth.
Bringing you his authentic perspectives on important topics.
They live in suburbs together. They live in the city together. They hang out together, all in the same family. We're the only idiots that fight because we want our voice to only be on one side. Like, does that even make any sense? And when the side loses, you lose everything. They, on the other hand, have a voice no matter what, because somebody that looks like them is always in control.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point.
Well, it's just a skewed system.
Of course it is.
It's a lot of judgment.
But answer my question, though. Should we let people go? Should we let people go? Like, let's just forget about bail altogether. And if your neighbor commits a homicide and kills people up... If you kill people and they next to you and you just let them come back and live right next to you, they can live upstairs from you. Let them come in your house.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point. This is the best radio show in the state of Wisconsin. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth App.
Now, he's the mayor of the city of Milwaukee. He's a young man. Give him a chance. I only complain about things that I care about. What I want you to do is pretend like I'm in St. Louis. And all I'm asking the mayor and the Common Council president and the Common Council, show me.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Dr. Ken Harris.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris, 833-212-1017 is
the number. See it? Okay, what is that? I'm going to put up number five. Ready? Point.
Number five.
Man, you got to get it the first time up. Oh, we're going to have fun with this all year. I wish I got mad about stuff. Like, you know, you didn't do this or that. I'm like, hey, it's live radio, dude. Anything goes. Everything goes. Giannis is out. Report just came over. Giannis is out. Call Kyle. Did he leave? Where's Kyle at? Kyle. Tell Kyle to come here. Go grab Kyle. Kyle. Where's Kyle? Kyle Wallace. Where are you, Kyle Wallace? Come into the studio, Kyle Wallace. Did y'all set him up? Y'all so mean. What, Kyle? I got to talk sports. It's going to be my number five. I'm going to have two number fives, by the way. But it's going to oh, wait a minute. Should I call him? Hang on. I got to talk sports. I got a question about sports. You know, since you're the new sports maven.
Did you tell him to turn the mic all the way up so I would
hear it?
Yeah.
Well, they was just being silly.
So what's up?
Dr. Giannis is out.
Yes.
So.
Soleus injury, calf injury.
Right. So it didn't have anything to do with his Achilles.
No, we don't say the A word. It did not. It was just a soleus. But the issue is, and I heard on Truth Be Told with DT and Telly, Tony Smith was talking about how the calf injuries is something that's very dangerous because of the fact that you can walk on it, but you can't run on it. So you feel like you're, you know, it's a little, you know, it's not as injured as it really is. Mm-hmm. And you rush back a little bit. So for me, we had Shams on our show earlier today. And Shams is known from The Athletic.
Right.
And he called in and he said 1 to 2 weeks. And I said, that would be silly. It'll be absolutely silly if you think that Giannis should be coming back in 1 to 2 weeks. Right. This is not, because we're not talking about, championship. We're talking about the next step in the injury, because he injured that leg before. He had a knee issue with that leg.
Right.
He had some other issue with that leg. That leg is an issue. If he rushes back and then all of a sudden he does something more tragic.
Tears something and now he needs surgery.
And now we're talking about next year, right?
Right.
So instead of missing out on some time this year, we're talking about missing out this year and next year.
And that's if he comes back from it.
Yeah, which I believe he'll come back from it.
He's young enough. Yeah. He's young enough.
But it still is missing time, right?
Right.
And if you do something serious, and if you do something serious, you're out for all next year.
Right.
Like, you're missing all next year.
And they've got to win two full series.
Well, they got to win more than that to get to the finals.
I'm just saying. You got, what, four?
And yeah, in order for four him to levels, come back.
So you've got two series that you absolutely have to get through.
And you would rather have Giannis on the back end. If the Bucks, with Damian Lillard and this roster, can't get out the first round without Giannis, then you don't deserve to be in a championship anyway.
Right. And it's only best of five. And then you get to best of seven. So, I mean, you're going to have to turn it up quick.
They switched it up.
So now it's seven and seven?
It's seven now.
And so it's seven for all?
It's seven for all now, which is actually a benefit for the Bucks, because you have one more game, which for me, I don't want Giannis to touch.
They just want more TV
money.
Revenue.
Everything's about money. Yeah, just like NFL, they care about player safety, but they add more games. And they fly teams to Brazil for games and allow them to play the following week. But yeah, I mean, for Giannis, I do not think that Giannis should come back in 1 or 2 weeks. Giannis should take the entire first series out. Giannis should be out at least 3 to 4 weeks just to rest up and make sure he is good.
Well, the seven games are going to take, 2 weeks?
It takes about 2 weeks if they go seven. But my hope is that
– maybe midway the second round.
Yes. That would be something that would make me feel more comfortable. Right. But I need for Giannis to be 100% healthy before he sets foot on that court.
Oh, yeah. Now, don't tell anybody I was talking about sports, because they think I don't know nothing about sports.
I will not say anything to anybody except for All Truth Nation.
Oh! Thanks, Kyle.
Thank you, sir.
All right, appreciate it. Kyle Wallace, ESPN, content director of 101.7 The Truth. It's one of those things where you don't think about it, but he's going to be out. And they've won without Giannis. And Damian's going to have to step up his leadership and not just be with Giannis, but actually be the leader. So that will be very interesting.
Number four.
This is a crazy story from Arizona. She's accused of trying to kill her husband with poison in his coffee. I ain't never gonna have somebody make me no coffee. My wife ain't making me no coffee. My daughters ain't making me no coffee. My friends, I drink coffee from a machine. Arizona woman pled guilty this week to attempting to poison her husband's coffee every day for months, court documents show. As part of a plea deal, Melody Filisano Johnson, who had been charged with attempted first-degree murder, pled guilty to two counts of a lesser felony charged by adding poison or a harmful substance to a food or drink, according to the court minutes of Pima County Superior Court. She will face a maximum of 2 years for each count. Her attorney did not immediately respond to CNN's request for comment. Would you? So the defendant's husband, Robbie Johnson, told investigators he believed she was trying to kill him to collect death benefits. Robbie Johnson said he first noticed a foul taste in his coffee in March of 2023 when he was an airman stationed in Germany. The Johnsons were still living together with their four kids, but they were going through a divorce. Robbie determined that he used pool testing strips to determine his coffee pot showed high levels of chlorine. Yeah, dude. So she got charged, and she's going to the Huskow, and, well, that's that.
Number three.
Milwaukee police are searching, believe it or not, today. It's just one of those days. This is probably the third day in a week. Police searched Milwaukee French Immersion School after receiving threats against the school today. After school officials received a bomb threat early today, police said they checked the exterior of the school about 2:30 a.m. and found that it did not appear to be broken into, according to an email from the department. They were called again around 11:15 a.m. today after another bomb threat, prompting a temporary evacuation of the school in the afternoon. So is all this because we passed a referendum? This is like the second or third school in about a week that has had a bomb scare or an imminent threat, and they had to, you know, take people out of school or cancel classes. I just find that interesting. Police say they used dogs and found no bombs after they searched the building. So that was at about 2 o'clock. They deemed it to not be credible. And the students were returning to the building to resume classes at 2 o'clock. At 2 o'clock. School is out at what? Okay. All right. That's just me.
Number two.
Well, from CBS 58, hours into the search yesterday for a 19-year-old woman missing for over a week now, family and friends made what they believe could be a disturbing discovery in the woods. Discovery was made about 75 yards off the golf course parking lot, back in the middle of the tall trees, and family and friends of Sade Robinson found what they say looked like a bone. Milwaukee County Sheriff's deputies were called to Warnemont Park that evening. Sorry, I got to stop for now because, like, that's a lot. I'm just overall sad, said Julia Ferreira, a family friend. There was a hush. And so this has been going on. She's been missing since April 1st. And so in earlier searches, they were able to locate another possible bone, also the 19-year-old's blanket. So as the story goes on and on and on, they're investigating, and the Sheriff's Department is not releasing any details, even though much of it has gotten onto social media and into the news, but they're not releasing any details about what was actually found. They're back there today, and they're going to continue to look and continue to search and continue to look for Sade Robinson. Connected, not connected. Again, my suggestion is to wait. Let the Sheriff's Department do their job. Let the Milwaukee Police Department and the state and the FBI do their job to connect the dots if it is, in fact, this person of interest. And so we'll know in a day or two, and they will get the DNA back from the crime lab, and We shall see.
Number one.
Well, authorities in Milwaukee County are also investigating the four separate scenes involving human remains in less than a week. The first of those scenes surrounded the discovery of a severed human leg in Warnemont Park we just talked about that might possibly be related to missing persons in Milwaukee. That was on April 2nd. A person of interest in the case appeared in court yesterday, April 9th, identified by the district attorney's office as 33-year-old Maxwell Anderson, 39 years old from the south side of, is he 39? Anyway, I know he lives on 39th and Oklahoma. In the same Milwaukee neighborhood, police were called for body parts or human remains this past Friday and Saturday and Sunday. Law enforcement have not said if the three Milwaukee cases or the Cudahy case are connected. 1 week after someone found it, he appeared in court. And family members say 19-year-old Shade Robinson reported missing and last seen on April 2nd. Said investigators invited them to the hearing. And so they're working to strengthen the case if this is in fact the person. They're working on it. Department of Justice is working on it. FBI, Milwaukee Police. And so given time, if they find evidence, it'll be brought to the prosecutor's office and they'll go from there. Prosecutors did ask a court commissioner for more time to make a charging decision and to keep Anderson in custody while they do so. One prosecutor wants to review blood evidence results and a court commissioner granted a 72-hour extension. Now, police have not shared how Anderson became a person of interest in the case. He has not been charged. So they found body parts, 30th and Lisbon, 31st and Walnut, 31st and Galena. Each scene was within a block or two of each. And part of the search party found a bone of some sort, but they don't know what else beyond that. And so they're working diligently to bring this to fruition and make sure they can make the identification. The suggestion is, this is me, let the police department, let the sheriff's department, let the state, let the FBI do their job. They are masterful and good at it when they want to be. They're masterful and good at what they do. Give them the space that they need. If you're going to go search, call. Check with the police department. See if the area that you're searching has been searched already or whether or not it's cordoned off and it's a crime scene. Don't go traipsing over areas that you could possibly destroy evidence. Check in, call, and say, hey, I want to go search. This is where we're thinking about going to search. Would it be okay? That's all. That simple, that easy. And that way you can help out the family, help out others. And they'll go from there. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I am your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. Hey, you want to turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary? You can do that with brand new Pella windows. Luxury look, sleek design, custom colors available. Guaranteed to give your home the extra pop it needs to entertain and keep you comfortable. It's the best of both worlds. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. So right now, today, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership. It's your living space and make it a place worth living. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That's Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Don't touch that dial. More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. Milwaukee Black Talk.
They think that black people don't wash their hands. So when they designed the automatic bathroom faucets and the automatic paper towel dispensers, they never thought to have that UV light be sensitive to or recognize black skin. They literally think, well, black people don't need paper towels. They don't wash their hands. So we don't need to have the sensors activate when a black person waves their hands. I'm not kidding you.
Listen to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes weekdays from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million. $1,000, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who you know, Denise, out of Evansville, and they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. And so we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We have already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
Your drink, sir?
This virtual vacation is brought to you by Milwaukee Mitchell International Airport. For the full experience, visit flymke.com to explore our many nonstop destinations. With super convenient parking and low fares, flying from Milwaukee makes traveling so easy, it's like starting your vacation early. Fly easy, fly MKE.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit amfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Come in with straight truth.
And the truth was, after November 3rd, after the election, poof, it was over. It was a political idea. I don't have to wait till it's said and done to realize we got played. I said it back then, and I stood 10 toes on it. I said, this ain't no black movement. This something else. Just because it say Black Lives Matter, I started looking at the movement and what was going on, and I said, this is a political agenda.
Catch the Tory Lowe Show every weekday from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris, 833-212-1017 is the number. Hey, Truth Nation, the One World Music Festival is coming to the Riverside Theater on Friday, April 21st. The music festival will feature some of the hottest local artists that you like. Chicken P, 414 Big Frank, JP, Joe Pablo, and many, many more. The One World Music Festival will also honor Milwaukee's legendary rap artists like the great Cuckoo Cal, Baby Drew, Ray Nitty, Homer Blow, and a whole lot more. Make sure you get your tickets to attend today. One World Music Festival, Friday, April 26th at the Riverside Theater, downtown Milwaukee. Doors open at 6 p.m. Get your tickets. Go to PabstTheaterGroup.com. That's PabstTheaterGroup.com. Search One World Music Festival. That's the PabstTheaterGroup.com and search One World Music Festival. Go hang out. Check it out. You can get it done. 833-212-1017 is the number. I love the summer, but I hate the summer because there's so much stuff to read. And it's a good thing. It's a great thing. 833-212-1017 is the number. Sandra, where you been? I've been waiting on you since last Thursday.
No, you haven't.
I have.
Didn't I call you Friday?
Hey, don't let the truth get in the way of a good story.
No, I know I didn't call you.
I know you did.
I think you had a guest, too.
I know you did. I'm just giving you trouble. Huh?
I'm going to call.
I know. I'm just checking on you. Make sure you are.
I'm not afraid of your trouble.
I'm just trying to make sure you are.
I'm not afraid of trouble.
I know you ain't a
person. I'm still alive. Okay? Mm-hmm.
See how she be chastising me? Alive. And then everybody screams at me on the radio, be like, hey, leave her alone. Why you always messing with Sandra? Goodness.
I got you some backup.
Yes, you do.
You got to be cool.
Can't be messing with the elders in
the
community.
Maybe they want to hear what I got to say.
Get broke off.
They want to hear what I got to say.
So what's so what do you think about this whole body thing?
Body parts?
Mm-hmm.
When I think about it, I think of Jeffrey Dahmer, because he started out as a kid. He didn't just start out as a grown-up.
Oh, yeah, he was killing stuff in Ohio. That's why he got sent to Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep. And then I think of Ed Gaines. He was digging up graves, peeing off of dead people. You remember that?
What's the guy from Chicago that killed the nurses? Richard Speck.
Spock.
Richard Speck.
Yes, I call him Spock. Yeah, him. Richard Speck. He broke in the dorms and killed nurses.
Yeah. And the only nurse that lived, and I remember because it was at the Michael Reese Hospital. They had a nursing school, and the only nurse that lived was the one that hid under the bed and pretended like she was dead or something like that.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah. There's a lot of that stuff going on. And, you know, back in Georgia when those boys, black boys were, you know, coming up dead. You know, it's a lot of stuff going on.
The Atlanta child murders.
Don't hear about it.
Atlanta child murders.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you don't hear about it, but it happens.
Oh, you heard about
it. You're talking about making yourself safe. You know, I be looking at some of everything. And you were talking about safety. Now, one thing I wanted to say, I wanted to ask about, okay, now a lot of people, because by this being boosted up, you know, to be scared, and there's so much crime in the city here, everybody I know is purchasing a gun. Now, a lot of times, if somebody's going to rob you, I'm thinking, they're thinking too, so I'm thinking they may be wanting to attack you in the back before you can get to your gun.
Okay.
So I just kind of wonder what's the thinking, how a person got to be able to get to their weapon fast enough for the attack.
There are a couple of different ways. I don't necessarily, I'm not a firearms trainer, nor do I play one on TV or radio. And I can't really give how you should respond, because that's a personal thing based on your level of experience, your training. They may hold certain people at a higher level of understanding, a higher level of reaction. It's all sorts of things that go into it that the DA is going to look at to determine whether or not you were acting as a citizen out of self-defense or whatever. You know, the law is a tricky thing. And, you know, lawyers have a tricky fraternity where they decided that we're going to speak in Latin and nobody else who hasn't been in the program can actually do it or teach it or even be a lawyer. So it's like a closed fraternity where you can't, you know, do anything. But I would suggest talking to an attorney, and maybe we'll have, you know what? We need to call the district attorney's office and get a district attorney and maybe a city attorney on the radio so that we can actually discuss. And we'll do that during law enforcement, black law enforcement. Anyway, law enforcement week, the week of May 12th.
So we can be conscious of it. There's some rules, so we can be conscious. But there are rules too that you got to kind of follow for yourself.
Yes.
Like, don't get gas at night. Because my daughter was getting gas at night, I had to tell her to stop. You know, some of these kids don't be thinking. You know, they get the gas at night. A lot of times, you smell that, put that skunk stuff coming out the windows and everything. And windows are so tinted, you can't see who's in it, so you don't even know who's gonna pull a gun on you. But I think that they should get that off the map there, because that tinted window thing is no good. But then they say, and then the shootings, when somebody do mass shootings,
right,
they like to do mass shootings because they get more attention.
Mm-hmm.
So I try not to go to the grocery store when it's not real crowded, because I'm retired too. So I can go super early if I want to, or I'll wait till, you know, most people go to work.
Right.
And, you know, that way it's not super crowded.
Okay.
And they show the Slender Man girls. They're trying to get out. So we got a lot of things to look at.
Yes, we do. Stay safe.
Oh, yeah, that's what everybody tells me. It's almost scary because everybody, last note they say, stay safe, you know?
All right.
I try.
Don't try. Do it.
Okay.
All right.
Well, look, you don't know, though. You don't know when the attack is going to come. So
that's
you just got to kind of look around. You
but
know.
You don't have to put yourself in a position to have it happen, Marcel. You know, you can do some things to mitigate it. Okay.
Right. I don't, because, you know, like I said, I can't beat nobody up.
Yep.
Okay, Dr. King.
All right.
Okay, bye.
Bye. You can beat somebody up. Let somebody mess with you enough. You done seen these old ladies and young kids beat the snot out of people because they were scared and somebody attacked them and they thought they was going to lose their life. I'm telling you. Kathleen on the talking text line said, Dr. Harris. You know you're in trouble when they say Dr. Harris. As a single 73-year-old lady, I would appreciate your input on pepper spray for safety. I'm out and about a lot. I was wondering what type or kind do you recommend as a retired man of the police force? Thank you again, Kathy. So, first of all, I wouldn't recommend any. I would recommend you go somewhere and get training on how to use it. So, one thing you can do is call your local police department and ask, are there any self-defense or training places that you would recommend? I think they still have OCO, Office of Community Outreach, with the Milwaukee Police Department. If they don't, call the police academy. Call the non-emergency number, 414-933-4444, during the day, like 8 to 4, and ask for the police academy. And I'm sure there's somebody there that can steer you in the right way or show you where you can go in order to just find a legitimate, you know, decent self-defense. And they may have some free. Maybe you can get a CCL, concealed carry license, which just doesn't include guns, right? There are other weapons, other things you may want to use to defend yourself. And so make sure you're within the law. Make sure you're doing it in the right way by getting the training from a concealed carry license instructor so you'll know what you can do, what you can't do, what your liability is, all those things so that you can do it. All right? 833-212-1017 is the number. Traffic, sports, and weather up next.
Don't touch that dial. More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 1017 The Truth. Here is Denise Thomas with her truth.
Truth Nation, there has been an ongoing debate in terms of what work ethic means, and primarily across generations. You hear phrases like, this new generation doesn't know the meaning of work. They're entitled. And the younger generation saying things like, the older people, they work way too hard and not smart enough. All perspectives have some extension of validity. I want to share with you something that I heard last weekend that really resonated with me as it relates to work ethic. And the quote was, a lot of people want to learn how to play the guitar, but they don't want to take the lessons. And so Truth Nation, as we continue to have ongoing conversations about the meaning of work and work ethic, I want to ask each of us to consider what work means to us. And in terms of what we are looking to gain from whatever aspect of work that we deliver every day, is it equal to what we want to gain? In other words, are you putting in the work that's not just short game or 60 seconds or less, but the work that is going to create a long impact on whatever return on the investment looks like for you? Let's start having more conversations about the meaning of work, making sure that we're aligned on what that looks and feels like, and ultimately not giving up on doing the work, because goodness knows, we got a lot of work to do.
This has been Truth Takes on the new 1017 The Truth. Listen to The Truth Be Told with DT and Telly weekdays from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m.
Gruber Law Office. One call, that's all.
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 Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
One call, that's all.
Are you or anyone you know looking for a job? Direct Connect MKE is a social media style platform that empowers you to grow your social network, find career opportunities, and connect with career specialists for success. Visit joindcmke.com today to learn how you can create a profile, upload your resume, and find access to information about jobs, job training, hiring events, and more. DCMKE is locally focused and equips you to grow your social capital and find opportunities that match your career interests. Visit joindcmke.com today and connect your dream to reality.
The traffic and weather update on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by the City of Milwaukee's Direct Connect MKE. Make connections and explore career opportunities by visiting directconnectmke.com. Things are still backing up on 894 southbound from just south of Greenfield Avenue down through the Hale interchange. So give yourself a little bit of extra time right now from the Zoo to the Hale. We're looking at about a 9-minute ride. Along southbound 43, little pockets of heavy traffic starting basically from Hampton all the way down past Capitol Drive. Northbound's pretty solid out of the Marquette all the way up to about Capitol Drive. From downtown up to Brown Deer Road, we're looking at a 13-minute ride. Southbound side's at 16. From Brown Deer Road into downtown. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, increasing clouds, a low of 46. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy, scattered showers and thunderstorms with a high of 56. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 101.7 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Julian Johnson. The Milwaukee Bucks get back in the win column after defeating the Boston Celtics 104-91 Tuesday. The Bucks hit the hardwood again versus the Orlando Magic tonight at Fiserv Forum. Coverage begins at 6:30 on 94.5 ESPN. The Milwaukee Brewers are now 7-3 to start the season. They defeated the Cincinnati Reds Tuesday 9-5. They face the Reds again tonight. Coverage begins at 5:05 on our sister station, 620 WTMJ. The Green Bay Packers are heading to Brazil for week one of their 2024 season. They'll play the Philadelphia Eagles in Sao Paulo on September 6th. This is the NFL's first ever game in South America. This sports update is presented by Associated Bank, proudly supporting our hometown teams, member FDIC.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. Chauncey, Sir Chauncey said, bump some pepper spray. Get your doggone permit and carry a Glock at all times. Come on, man. Come on. 833-212-1017 is the number. Winky Blue, you're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth. What's going on?
Hey, good afternoon to you, Doc.
How are you, sir?
I just, you know, it bothers me that you are actually doing the mayor's job. You know, and the county executive.
We have not heard a word from the mayor. You are 100% correct.
This is what I'm tripped at. And the county exec, a body part was found in one of his parks. And this dude ain't came out to give the family no condolences. Are they scared?
Well, we don't know. We can't get a family condolences and we don't know who it is.
Well, we don't know who it is, but we know it's somebody's family.
Right. Like even
we don't have to be specific. Listen, then to come out and give some comfort to the public.
Right.
You coming out, giving the public some sort of comfort, and you giving them, hey, look, we don't know what we're up against, so what we need to do is put our head on a swivel and keep watch.
That's right.
You know, these are things that I look for the mayor to do when they over there on 30th Street. Okay? Mm-hmm. When it came out on 30th, and I expect for Crawley to have been over there at the park where they found a body part. These are things, and then he was supposed to offer, you know, the stuff that you're doing right now. You know, some self-defense, not physical self-defense, but just, you know, things to be aware of, your surroundings. Because we really don't know what we're up against because ain't nothing being said, you know. And I understand that they don't want to get the public in an uproar. And I listen to these people about the guns. Guns are fine. But when somebody up on you right quick, they're going to take your gun. That's what's happening, too. A lot of guns are being taken, okay? There was a guy on 27th and Capitol at the gas station, older guy, and he had his little gun on the side of him. And I paid for my gas, and I came out, and I seen his little gun. Well, when he came out, them boys hit him so hard, man, and had that gun out of his side pocket, his holster, and going up between the buildings before he hit the ground.
But that's just one person. That doesn't mean everybody that carries a gun is going to get hit upside the head and a gun taken.
No, no, that was just something I was saying.
Uh-huh.
But what I'm simply saying is that if somebody's got the up on you, the gun really does nothing. I will give somebody some good advice. I heard, what's her name, the lady that always calls in, I think, Sandra. She made some good points about going at night. I'll tell somebody else something, too. If you don't want to get jammed up in certain areas, don't make your last store run when the store is closing, because mm-hmm. that's when all of the loot is in there, and that's when the robbers mostly got their eyes set on liquor stores and other stuff. So you want to get caught in the middle of a robbery most of the time. Some of these robberies don't even go reported because the people don't want to have to deal with their licenses being attacked when it's time for renewing. Hey, you don't want to get in a jam, don't go in there when the stores is closing, when the liquor store closing, when the late night stores,
right.
because that's the time that most folks will be attacked. But anyway, that was just my thing, and I had to bring that up, man, and I appreciate what you're doing because we ain't heard from them characters.
All right, I'll be
trying. Newly elected.
I appreciate you, Winky. 833-212-1017 is the number. So when it's lighting outside, like, what do you do when you're outdoors? If there's no – first of all, there is no clear scientific proof that increasing your lighting outside deters crime. Did you know that? It may make us feel better, but hasn't really been shown to make us safer. So what does it allow is for us to see potential threats. So if you're in your car – use light to ensure safety. Park near a light source, yet not close enough to be blocked in. Like, if possible, back into a space. I don't care whether or not somebody put no backing into a space. I don't care. I am backing into a space so that when I drive out, I can see where I'm going. You ever been in a rush and tried to back up? You end up hitting somebody, tearing up your car. So what do? You make sure that doesn't happen by backing into a space. That's just me. In the workplace, know your entry and your exit places. Know how to get into and out of a place, ingress and egress. Also, if you're visiting somebody, make sure you know where the door is. Watch how many locks they got on their door. Watch if they leave the door unlocked. You know, all little, you know, it might make you paranoid. It might make you go, you know, I'm kind of scared. But really what you should do is trust your instincts. If you think you don't feel safe, you're not safe. Get away as soon as possible. Trust your instinct. But show some confidence. Walk like you know where you're going. You know, 9 times out of 10, you're walking down the street and somebody speaks to you from a porch or a group of guys. Hey, how's it going, Miss Lady? Hey, what's up, dude? Say hello. Like, it's not a big deal. Say what's up. Say what's going on. But don't look like an easy target. Robbers want somebody who will provide the least resistance. I remember one time I was in Chicago and I was over by Rush Presbyterian St. Luke's. I don't know what the name of it is now today. And I'm walking on the west side, and I'm going. And as I walk past the guy, I look at him, and he had his hands in his pocket, and he had a hoodie up, and he's just walking, had his hand down. And I saw him glance up and look at me and glance up and look at me. So I kept looking at him, right? And so as he walked past, I watched him, and then I turned around and had my – and was facing him while I was walking backwards. And when he turned around to come after me, and when he saw me, he was startled, and I was looking at him like, what? Because he was ready to come behind me and hit me upside the head or pretend like he had a gun, and he ran. Usually, if you just walk with some confidence, people leave you alone. But don't put yourself in a situation where you have to, I got to make myself walk with confidence, and I got to be careful. You might want to do the buddy system and go with somebody. When you go out and go visit somebody, let somebody know where you're going, what you're doing, who you're with. You know, put it on an app where you can send it out to everybody. Hey, I'm going to this address. I'll be here for about 15 minutes. And if I'm not out in 15 minutes, here's where I am. And you can drop a pin and send it to everybody. This is where I'm at. Boop, and done. You know, little things like that. But in the end, what it really takes, be observant. It's kind of that simple.
Don't touch that dial. More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, join the Truth Team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs and Safe and Sound.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella Windows. The luxurious look, sleek design, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home the extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. At Pella, we see windows differently. We have the highest rated energy efficient products and a complete range of durable, functional, and high quality products that bring out the best of your home. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. That's right, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Eagle Sports Range has an unbeatable offer on concealed carry license classes. For just $49, enroll in their three-hour class led by expert instructors prioritizing safety. Learn laws, techniques, and mindset for responsible carrying. Stick around for an optional hour of range time with instructors included in the package. Practice under professional guidance and gain confidence. Open 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. every day at 2525 East Layton Avenue in Cudahy. Secure your spot at eaglesportsrange.com. Eagle Sports Range, where safety meets skill.
When it comes to getting the smile of your dreams, you can't just trust anyone. So look no further than Bubon Orthodontics. Bubon Orthodontics is Wisconsin's number one Invisalign provider and has been providing the best value for braces and Invisalign since 1993. With 15 convenient locations, you're sure to find one in your area. Schedule your free consultation today. Call or text 262-522-7447 or visit bubonortho.com. Bubon Orthodontics, a family treating families.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. Truth Nation, tonight is the night. Tune in 6 o'clock p.m. for the Thanalysis podcast on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth. Thanalysis will be joined by Duke basketball legend Jay Williams and Bucks guard Malik Beasley. They will have a real conversation about life as well as diving deep into the NBA world. Don't miss the Thanalysis podcast on The Truth right here tonight, 6 o'clock, right after Truth in the Afternoon on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk. Make sure you check it out. Also want to remind you, April is one of my favorite months of the year, Literacy Month, and The Truth has you covered on learning about how you can best manage your finances. All April, we'll be speaking with representatives from Educators Credit Union to discuss financial strategies and tools they offer their members to help enhance your financial management skills. Financial Literacy Month on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by Educators Credit Union. Achieving more together. 833-212-1017 is the number. The Dallas Police Department, when did this come out?
Ooh.
The Dallas Police Department has issued a warrant for Kansas City Chiefs wide receiver Rashee Rice concerning a 6-car crash in the Texas City on March 30th. Rice, 23, is wanted on one count of aggravated assault, one count of collision involving serious bodily injury, and 6 counts of collision involving injury. Theodore Knox, 21, is also wanted on the same charges. They were not in custody on Wednesday afternoon. That's this afternoon. And passengers in all the vehicles will not be charged with a crime. Rice drove a Lamborghini SUV while Knox drove a Chevy Corvette that police say were both speeding on a Dallas highway when they lost control and crashed. Nobody died before people were hurt. Investigators say a number of people got out of the Lamborghini and Corvette and left the crash scene without providing insurance information or checking to see if anybody was hurt. Rice released a statement on social media saying that he's taking full responsibility for his role in the crash. Rice's attorney, Royce West, also said that Rice was driving the Lamborghini SUV involved in the crash. Why he left was a good question that's still being investigated. TMZ reported that Rice owned the Corvette and leases the Lamborghini. Rice is a native of the Dallas suburb and a Southern Methodist University graduate, won a Super Bowl with the Chiefs in his rookie year, finished with the second most received yards behind tight end Travis Kelce. So, first he was up, and now he's down. So, we'll see how that career goes, because you know how it is when we get in trouble. They're going to find extra stuff. Light pole was down. You knocked that down. Sir, I don't have any paint transfer for my car, that light pole. We're going to blame it on you anyway. I'm just kidding. 833-21. I'm just saying. Computer over here making all kind of noise. Let me shut this thing down. They probably got a ghost in the machine. You ever heard that phrase, ghost in the machine? Dude. I ain't heard nothing. Like, it's just like, was I pretty good? Like, you'd be like, have you heard of this? And they'd be like, no. I don't know if it's a no, like, I honestly don't know. Can you enlighten me? Or is it a, no, that's stupid. Like, you can never, like, you ever talk to somebody and they told you something like, no. But you can see in their eyes, like, you no good, blankety, blank, blank, blank. Like, really? Like, really? You take all that? You take all that? Andy said, Dr. Ken, giving you an update. My son is back in the police academy. He wanted me to let you know he still talks about the talk you had with him. He's back in? That's what I'm talking about. You tell him to come see me. Or contact me. I think you still got my number. Come have him contact me, or you contact me, whatever y'all need. I want to be at graduation. I want to be at graduation. All right? Sherry said, Dr. Ken, tell Winky that David Crowley was on the news today speaking about the body parts. Okay. Good. Good for him. Ray said, the parks belong to the county, not just the city of Milwaukee. We need to stop pointing fingers. Nobody's pointing fingers. What are you talking about? He went on to say, let the law officials do their job. We cannot blame the mayor for any of this. Just because you like the mayor, ain't nobody blaming the mayor. We're just saying, speak up. Come out and show support. And support the police. Support the sheriff's department. And first of all, everybody already knows that it's the parks. They were found in Cudahy Park, and then they found the other parts, and they think it's connected, and the sheriff's department is investigating. Along with the police, along with the state, along with the Fed. So what are you talking about? What you talking about, Willis? Paul said, why does it take Rice 2 days to report to police then? Well, because he's a punk. He's a wimp. They made that musical about him. Wimpy Kids, that's him. That's him. He's just one of them people, you know? And he walked away from a crime scene. Now, that's character. You also have to look at the fact that he's 23. So his brain isn't fully developed, and he's a millionaire. So, you know, he thinks he can actually do what he wants to do, go where he wants to go, say what he wants to say. And I think he found out that it's really not true. That he found out that it's not true, right? So, you know, that's just how it goes. And he'll find out when he go to court. Now, he caused a crash with six cars and then left. Like, dude, where were you going? Now, watch this. He would have been better staying there, being intoxicated, getting a ticket, gone about his business. But the fact that you ran? Yeah, that's not looking good. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. The Thanalysis Podcast is coming up next. Make sure you hang around and check it out. Then after that, Tory Lowe will be gracing your... See, I don't know if you're on a radio or phone or internet or like whatever. He's going to be up. And then I'll see you in about 22 hours. Remember, I'll be live from the Alpha Phi Alpha Midwestern Regional Convention tomorrow and Friday. So, you know, if you want to walk through the Bear Center and say, what's up? You know, come holler. God bless. Take care. Thank you, Jason. Appreciate you. I'm out.